The dad pour us all. Glory, glory, glory. You're so worthy of our praise. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. There is no other like you, Father. There is no other. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. We say amen. Amen. And amen. Glory. 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 Understand. Had a wonderful gathering at 5 o'clock this morning. Amen. While Pastor Hill is coming forward, if any of you would like to come forward and give your testimony about this morning, we'd love to hear your eye with. I want to hear your eye with. Glory. Yes. I truly missed these Tuesday mornings. It was really the foundation that that established me in the Lord. It was those times that I spent with Pastor Hill that really got me grounded in my bearings, and I knew where I needed to go and which direction I was going. So those Tuesday mornings at 5 a.m. was the most precious time for me, and the most critical time for me, because it had not been for those mornings, I can't be so sure that I would have lasted as long as I have. So I thank God for Pastor Hill and all of those others that supported the 5 a.m. prayer, the Bible studies. It's just a wonderful time to be with the Lord. So we hope it never ends, and it's not going to end. Yes, amen. Amen. So here's Pastor Hill. Glory.
So I just want to exhort you, don't miss all of these 5 o'clock session this morning. I begin the mornings because you seem like in the morning it's just so easy to just flow. Yeah. Amen. I enjoy, amen, just seeing Sister Sherry Brown floating around here. Yeah. Amen. All it takes just a few to catch on fire. Amen. And where it just impacts everybody. Sometimes I just like to be under the anointing. I don't have to say something all the time. I don't always have to be leading it or, amen, or saying anything out loud. But I just like to, amen, sometimes just coast on the prayers of the saints. You know, Monday night, Brother Rod got loose. Yeah, we was all coasting. You can just shut down and just enjoy his. All right, just turn to page 31. This is the art of creating the atmosphere that you really want to experience when you're worshiping the Lord. This is the matter, this little praise, little great prayer book. You have yours? You don't have yours? Okay. All right, this is the prayer that's consistent with the teaching that we are doing now. And it would be good for you to focus on that because this kind of project most of the points that we are making during this series of teaching on the Lord's compassion. Once we can conquer that, once we can get that message into our prayer, praise, and worship vocabulary, then you're going to enjoy a much higher level of praise because it's going to be exhorting the Lord and expressing the extent of His compassion. And whether you believe it or not, that area of the Word that deals directly with the Lord's compassion is the type of teaching and meditation that will build your faith, amen, sky high. It will build it higher than any other portion of the Scripture because this is showing, amen, this is focusing on God's greatest attribute. God's greatest attribute is showing favor. Yes. Amen. Displaying His love. Amen. Love in action. God is a God of benevolence. Yes. Amen. He just longs to bless us and to release His blessings into our lives. Yes. And when we can focus on God's willingness, God's eager desire to release these blessings into our life, and we can get those scriptures, amen, embedded in our prayer vocabulary, and just let those words come out during our prayer. Sometimes it might come out in a song. Sometimes it might come out in the spirit. Amen. But this is going to help you to really develop confidence in God's willingness and God's eagerness, amen, to release His fullness into your life. And you get very comfortable when you are convinced that God wants you blessed and He wants you blessed more than you want to be blessed. So let's look at these scriptures here. And Father, I thank You for making total provision for all my need. Amen. Those in the past, those now, and those yet to come. Yes. Amen. Your gracious heart, that's what we talked about yesterday, being disposed to show in favor, is a demonstration of Your great love, mercy, and care for me. Amen. That's just enough right now, almost to, amen, to warm your heart and break your downs and draw tears from your eyes. Amen. Just that one paragraph, see, expressing how God has made total provisions for all of our needs. We can remember a lot of these needs God has fulfilled in the past. You can look back and count your blessings and you can name them one by one. Amen. Those things that God is doing in our lives right now, how many know that the Lord is doing some things for us now? He who has begun the work, the good work He shall what? Continue. Amen. How many is a witness that God is continuously, consistently, right now, He's performing His word and making His word reality in our lives now. Oh, that's enough to just walk up and down these aisles. Hey, and just rejoice in the things that God is doing in the now. Hey, how many can say he's the peace that passes all my understanding? He's the joy that's unspeakable and full of glory. Hey, somebody said the Lord is the strength of my life. He's the light of my salvation. And somebody said that of his fullness I have received, and grace upon grace. Oh, the Lord is working now. Hallelujah. The Lord is at work now, and he's working his will and the do and the ability to do his pleasure. He's doing that in our lives. And the quicker we can recognize what God is doing in the now, hey, hiya, the happier we will be. Hey, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, how many glad that the Lord is working his will. Hiya, yeah, 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 yeah. He's working his will and the ability. Oh, God, to do his good pleasure. He's working that ability within us now. And we can rejoice and be glad. Hallelujah, praise him. As a father loves and pities his children, so doth you love and pity those who fear you. Oh God, hallelujah. You are my Lord, the faithful God, the Father of mercies, and the God of all comfort. And it is because of your kind nature. The Lord is good, isn't it? It's because of his kind nature and manifold mercies that we are sustained and are not consumed. Oh, yes. Great is your what? Faithfulness. I want to get Sister Denise to stand up right now and say, great is our faithfulness. Amen. She'll be ready one of these times soon. Hallelujah. She's probably ready right now. Hallelujah. His mercies are new what? Every morning. Hey. Amen. They were shown new this morning, weren't they? When we step in this auditorium this morning, we can feel his mercy. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is what? Good. And his mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Lord, your mercy endureth forever. Amen. There's a chapter in Psalms 134, something like that. In every scripture, every verse, it says his mercy endureth forever. Y'all remember that chapter? Every verse, it ends that way. His mercy endureth forever. His mercy endureth forever. His mercy endureth forever. Oh, it's about time for the people of God to say amen with the Lord. Say what the Lord says. The Lord is good and his mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord what say that his mercy endureth forever. Oh, yes, we thank God for his mercies. His mercies is all of these blessings. Scripture says he daily loaded us with what? Benefits. We can't find nothing to praise him for. Why do we have to be so droopy and dry and glory and distracted and hiya, hiya? We ought to be bubbling over with joy. David said, my cup is what? Running over. Hey, hallelujah. Praise your name. Oh, I wish we could muster up some joy from somewhere. Hey, hallelujah. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Okay. Are you forgiven? These are the benefits that we can just praise him for. Brother Travis enumerated a whole lot of these. You've forgiven all my iniquities. You healeth all my diseases. You redeemeth my life from destruction. You crowneth me with loving kindness and tender mercies. You satisfieth my mouth with good things, so that my youth is renewed like the eagles. Oh, praise God. How many love those mercies? Forgiveth all your iniquity. That's a good mercy, isn't it? Amen. The scripture says, as far as the east is from the west, God removes our sins. And when we miss it in our everyday walk, the Bible says if we confess it, amen, and what? Forsake it, the Lord will have what? Mercy. Oh, God, it's Sure is good to be able to live a life free from condemnation. There's there now no condemnation, because Jesus forgiveth all of our what? Iniquities, and he healeth all of our what? Diseases. Hallelujah. How many know that God is our protector as we go out, as we come in, as we lay down, and as we get up? Oh, it's the Lord. No wonder David said, the Lord is my refuge, and the Lord is my strength, and he's a present help in the time of trouble. So I lift up my eyes. Oh, glory. Praise God. I lift up my eyes. Come on, lift up your eyes. I lift up my eyes unto the hills, from which cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord. The Lord that made heaven and earth. Oh, he will not suffer. Hallelujah. Father, all that you've done and provided us have come through our Lord Jesus Christ. This was your plan before the beginning of time. Christ being willing to lay down his life before the world began is the reason why you could be so gracious and show us these mercies and such great kindness, which we see revealed through your compound names of Jehovah. In these names, your benevolent and compassionate heart is disclosed. Through these names, you have covenanted through your Spirit to be the Lord there always with me. Oh, I love it. The Lord is always there with me. That's a covenant promise and provision. The Lord is always there. He said, hello, I will be with you always. Oh, you go through the rough and the tough and the ups and the downs and the ins and the outs. Hey, hallelujah. Amen. The Lord is always there. Sometimes your friends say, I'm with you, brother. I'm with your friend. I'm with you, James. Through the thick and thin. And when the thick come, they thin. But the Lord is always there. How many here say, he's always there. That's the name you want to hang on to. Amen. Jehovah Shammah. Everybody just said Jehovah Shammah. All right. Amen. Shammah. So when you begin to praise the Lord, you can just let it slip out something. Jehovah Shammah. Oh, boy, you can make some music to the Lord, can't you? Jehovah what? Shammah. That means the Lord what? He's right here. Oh, he's right with me. Hallelujah. I go take a step forward. The Lord what? He's taking that step with me. When I take a step to the side, the Lord is what? He's going to follow me there to my side. When I go to the right, the Lord is there. The Bible says, surety, goodness, and what? Mercy shall what? Follow me. See, God's Spirit, God's presence has promised to be with us always. Amen. We can always depend on God. What? His goodness and mercy following us. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes. That's a pretty good promise and covenant. Yes. Oh, I love that. The Lord of peace. Yes. Ooh, Jehovah Shalom. Somebody said Jehovah Shalom.
Jehovah Shalom.
Amen. In your prayer time, you can just say Jehovah Shalom. Amen. Just haul off and say it. That means the Lord my peace. And the more you sin, the more peace you're going to have. That's how you get God to release peace in your life. You have to acknowledge that he's Jehovah what? Shalom. Oh, Jehovah Shalom. Oh, lift your hands and Lord, you're Jehovah Shalom. Shalom, shalom, my peace that passes all understanding. Hey, the peace of all understanding shall keep my heart and my mind in perfect peace. Oh, how many thank God for that peace tonight. Oh, the Lord my provider. That's Jehovah Shalosh, Jireh. Jehovah who? Jireh. Amen. So you can haul off anytime and pray. Just think of one or two of these. And boy, that'll take your prayer and your prayer a notch higher. Jehovah Jireh. Just holler out, Jireh, Jehovah Jireh. Amen. You are my what? Provider. You might be having, you might have a few bills that's lagging. You might have some commitments that you can't make. Amen. But you need to acknowledge that God, amen, Jehovah is your what? Is your provider. Amen. There's nothing wrong with, amen, bursting out. Amen. And just shouting it out. Amen. These are names designed to get you more aware that God has covenant to be everything that you need Him to be for you. The Lord my banner, the Lord my shepherd, the Lord my righteousness, the Lord my physician. Father, the things you have done for me have not been due to what I merit. How many can attest to that? It has not been. All of these provisions you have made, it's not because I merit them. I ain't been that good. I ain't done nothing to deserve this, all of this. Hey! Oh, God, the things you have done for me have not been due to what I merit of good works which I have performed, but because of your graciousness. Amen. Amen. God is gracious. Everybody just say, God is gracious. He's gracious. It's because of your graciousness and kind nature. You are full of compassion, ready to forgive, and plenteous in mercy. Because you delighted in mercy, you are ever looking from one end of the earth to another to show yourself strong on the behalf of those whose hearts are trusting and relying upon you. Your desire to bless me and meet all my needs is more than I want to see my need met myself. Thank you for your unspeakable gift. Now you can extract a whole lot of prayer, amen, language and conversation and phrases and things to release, amen, during your prayer time just from this little, amen, prayer of thanksgiving and praise. Amen. That's how you build, amen, a very powerful and effective prayer life. You have to extract out of the word the things that God is all about. Amen. Amen. Praise God. I like to see that brother Trevor. He's following, amen, this pattern also. Amen. He started talking about the Holy Spirit tonight. Holy Spirit is my God. He's my teacher. Amen. You can name a dozen things that the Holy Spirit is designed to do in your life. And amen, if you go, just go down the list. Amen. And find out all that the Holy Ghost is to you. Boy, that can empower your prayer life to no end. Amen. This is the secret of building your prayer life. Amen. You just focus on what God is doing and what God is releasing in your life through His Word. All right, I like that. Praise God. Every good and perfect gift cometh from above and cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. Amen. Everybody just said every good and every what? Perfect gift cometh down from where? Above, from the Father of what? Lights, with whom is what? No variableness, neither what? Shadow. In other words, God ain't gonna what? Take you out in the middle of a river and what? Amen and amen and forsake you. He gonna put you on the limb and cut it off. In Him there's no what? Variableness, neither shadow turn. How many know you get with people that they change they change horses in the middle of the stream? You ever seen people like that? Well, they change their mind. I promise you. Promise you stuff, and boy, when the time comes for them to make it good, amen, they're on a different page. All they got a different story. But God is what? He's consistent. He changes not. How many can appreciate the fact that you can always trust Him and depend on Him? You can go back 5, 6, 7, 8,000 years from the beginning. Amen. And you never seen God being unfaithful to His word, to His promise, even one time. You never find it in the Bible. He's never been unfaithful to His word. He's the faithful God that keepeth covenant with them that love Him. Amen. And with them that obey Him. Amen. To 1,000 generations. Amen. God is faithful. Lift your hands and say, God, you are faithful. Amen. Praise God. For you, O Lord, you openeth your hands and loadeth us with benefits daily, satisfying the desire of every living thing. For you are Lord of all, and is nigh unto and rich unto all of them that call upon you, to all that call upon you in what? True. Amen. You are not just willing to respond to my need, but full of, see, this is exactly what we've been talking about the last week or two. You are not just willing to respond to my need, but full of eager yearning. You are eagerly awaiting the opportunity to release your blessings on me in great provision. Profusion, that means great abundance. You are eagerly waiting the opportunity to release your blessings on me in great profusion. It is when I receive from you and my prayers are answered and my need is met that my joy is full. So you can see how your joy is going to be full. Okay, it tells you exactly how your joy can be full. It is when you receive, when I receive from you and my prayers are answered and my need is met, that my joy is what? Full. Yes. Amen. Your desire for me is that my joy be what? Full. Inasmuch as you did not spare, Brother Travis, you read this too. Inasmuch as you did not spare your own son, but delivered him up for us all, it is evident enough for me to know that you are not a tight-fisted God. Amen. This is what we just got to get over real bad, because a lot of times people just think that God just going to do so much. Amen. He's not going to do it for me. You are not a tight-fisted God, but God who is in the business of, he's not in the business of withholding blessings from you. If you did not hold back your best, amen. You're talking to God. Well, Father, if you didn't hold back your best, which is your son, you will not refuse to give me or hold back the rest. If you didn't hold back your best, you will not refuse to give me or hold back the rest. Amen. Praise God. That's a strong statement. Because Jesus was offered for us all and have become our merciful and faithful high priest. That's the position he's operating in now in heaven. He's our merciful and faithful high priest. So he can do a lot more now because he's at the right hand of God. Amen. And he can work through his spirit in everybody at the same time, releasing these blessings. The reservoir of blessings has been enlarged and the fountains of blessings has become full to overflowing, causing your grace to be poured out and released into my life in great abundance or profusion. Father, I thank you and bless you for your manifold mercies and for your abundant grace. Amen. So this is going to be the model prayer, the prayer that you want to resort to. Amen. To help develop your compassion, prayer language, because it tells a whole lot about the Lord's compassion in these particular verses. So I want to encourage you to just focus on those. When you get to prayer in the morning, just read over those. Amen. And say them out loud and say them to yourself. I think that this will be a great blessing to you. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your hands. Hey, let's stand on your feet now. Just turn all the way around. Say, Lord, you're good and your mercy. You're good and your mercy endureth forever. Maybe we better say, the Lord, you're the strength of my life. If y'all time, you're the strength of my life. All right, praise God. Anybody else have anything you want to share before I give it back to Brother Travis? Amen. Anybody have anything you want to share? Amen. Brother Wayne, you got it. Amen. Praise God. You feel more strength now? Hello, you feel blessed? Hey. All right, we'll just thank God for his goodness. In the morning, we're going to hit this place at 5 o'clock sharp. Amen. We're looking for somebody to just run up and down these aisles. Screaming. Rejoicing. Praising God. Waving their hands. And hallelujah. Shouting the victory. Yes. Amen. Because the Lord is for us and the Lord before us. Amen. Who shall be against us? Come on, brother. Brother Charles.